about the next 15 minutes, which we're going to soon enter, and my friend here, LeeGale Gruen, an actress who wrote a book about her father and herself and how they got along and how he helped her.
Right, helped you, would you say?
Well, he attended an acting class with me. We attended a senior acting class.
Okay.
Yes.
It's not like climbing a mountain, but to do it with your father is sort of a warming experience for
yes.
everybody, both the father and you and the people around you who witnessed it.
Yes.
Who did the witnessing?
The class members and the audience in our senior showcases.
Oh, was it a regular school like UCLA or what?
No, it was a school in Santa Monica, California for seniors. They had classes for seniors. And when I retired from my career, my 37-year job as a probation officer for Los Angeles County, mm-hmm. I was looking around for something to do, and I heard about this school, Emeritus College, it's called, and I looked in their catalog. There was an acting class. I'd never done anything like that in my life. And I'd always been nervous, had
really?
Stage fright talking in front of large groups. Mm-hmm. I don't think I ever would have taken the class, but I thought that you just sat in your seat and went around the room. Everybody read a line or two out of a play or something. My first day at the class, a man asked me to come up to the front of the class and read a scene with him. I was so nervous, I couldn't believe I had to go up in front of the class in front of everyone. And he handed me a scene from Death of a Salesman, and I started reading. I was very shaky, very nervous, and all of a sudden something very funny happened to me. I totally forgot that a crowd of people were staring at me. I became so immersed in the role, and when I was done, everyone clapped, because they clap for everyone, that's the protocol, but I was hooked.
Oh, good for you.
I was totally hooked.
Admitting it is good.
Totally hooked on acting. And about 2 weeks later, my mother died, and my father, who was 85 at the time, I was 60, he was so depressed, so morose, and he normally was an outgoing and charismatic personality. So I just blurted out to him, come with me to my acting class, Daddy. I don't know why I said it, and I finally talked him into it. We went. He didn't know if he wanted to. He was quiet in the beginning, but little by little he kind of blossomed. And by the end of the class, he wanted to know what time I was picking him up next week for our class.
Good for you. Well, I see what I'm hearing here from both ladies is therapy, because I'm coming from that training. This therapy over here with acting was an outgoing therapy that she shared with her father. And this kind of therapy, such as I'm pushing myself to the top of the mountain.
Yes, it is like therapy, Dr. Marcia.
I agree with that. I hear it.
Mm-hmm.
And from you, I also hear it.
Yes.
It's a different kind, but that's what it is.
Yes.
So once you found out that that was helpful, you said it yourself, hooked.
Oh, I was totally hooked.
So
well, as
I
a result
admire
of,
you.
As a result of my class, we attended that class together for 3 years. And I actually went on to become an actress in my senior years,
yes,
which
I'm
is what I do
that
now.
Here.
Yeah.
I'll tell you what this lady did. It's her vita. And I'll tell you what it says. It says she was on Jane Fonda's video for exercise, which was the first video ever made so women could exercise to it.
Well, no, this was 2 years ago. Jane
oh,
Fonda.
Oh, not in the beginning.
Not in the beginning. No, now
oh,
she's,
I
last
see.
Few
it
years,
was,
she's been
2005,
making
it was written in Time Magazine, and in the LA Times, 2006.
Those were write-ups about me. The Jane
yes.
Fonda, is she's been putting out exercise videos aimed at the
well,
baby
boomers.
Taking
a break.
Yeah.
Okay, they're taking a break, the boys. But she did, you were in them.
Yes.
Some of them.
Yes.
That's what I had out of here.
Yes.
Okay. I think that's great.